and action.
Hey, you!
Hey, you!
Hi!
We're the Kids Bop Rappers.
And we're here to teach you some dope rap songs.
All about you. We'll make it as easy as
one, two, three!
And don't worry, Mom and Dad.
These rap songs are cool to do around the house.
And school.
Okay, cut.
Who farted?
Megan.
Yeah, it was definitely Megan.
That wasn't me.
Yeah. Okay, listen. Okay, this is a really hard thing to take out in post. So I'm going to need whoever did it to stop.
Okay.
Yep.
Okay, can we maybe text take it from the next part of the script?
Yeah,
okay.
Cool.
Great.
Right.
Okay. Okay, everyone ready?
Yep.
Action.
Let's get started.
We're going to make this real simple. When I say blank, you say your name.
Go!
My name is blank and I'm here to say...
Your turn, kids! Good job!
Next, say your favorite thing in the world when I say blank.
Go!
That I love blank in a major way.
Your turn, kids!
Okay, cut!
No.
Okay, cut!
Seriously, who keeps farting?
Cool.
No, it's not me. Maybe it's you.
Trust me, if it was me, I would have said something.
Oh, really?
I always do.
Yeah. Ladies, we don't have a lot of film left. And it's seriously hard to take those farts out in post. Okay?
Yep.
All right. Let's move on.
All right. Great.
Okay, and action.
I bet you didn't even realize that you just rhymed.
Now we're gonna put it all together.
My name is, and I'm here to say that I love in a major way. Your turn, kids.
Yay!
Okay, cut.
It stinks in here. Okay? Seriously? You can't keep their gas in their ass.
Sorry, I think my milk was expired this morning.
I had one of those vegan burritos for lunch.
This is my first paid gig and I get gas.
Okay, me too.
Okay.
All right.
Okay.
Okay, so let's move on. All right, let's take it from the top maybe.
Okay.
Great.
Okay, and action.
Who knew painting could be so therapeutic?
You deserve this. You work too hard.
I know. Thank you so much again for taking me here today.
Of course. And now we got some like cool, cute things for our new place.
Oh, well, looky here. A whole goddamn place filled with naked pottery. Oh my gosh. Shiver me Timberlake, they got porcelain puppy shakers. Oh, this is the cutest thing since a baby sneezing. Oh my God, excuse me, can I paint too? Excuse me. Okay, well, I'm gonna take that as a yes. Oh, hi ladies. My name is Mildred Stevens. May I sit with you?
Oh, sure. Hi Mildred, my name is Michelle. This is my wife, Megan.
Hi.
Oh, wow. Holy skunks! Wives! Oh, that is very cool. Yeah, I'm a widow, actually.
Oh, I'm so sorry.
Well, thank you so kindly. You know, Fred was such a nice man. I just don't have the heart to change my last name back to my maiden one. Plus, it blows leaves.
What is it?
Hymen.
Yikes.
Yep, Stevens is boring as hell, but anything's better than hymen. How did you two decide which name to take?
Oh, we hymenated.
Well, that's very fancy.
So, Mildred, what do you do for a living?
Oh, I'm a school bus driver. Proud yellow racer on the road since 92.
Oh, wow. Is that a tough job?
You bet your pineapples it is. You know, it's really rewarding, too, though. You know, I leave an impression on those kids. Every year they get me Christmas gifts.
Being the Jehovah's Witness boy gets me a little treat.
Oh, that's so sweet. Mm-hmm.
I wouldn't do anything else. What about you ladies?
Oh, I'm a chef.
And I work in advertising.
Oh, damn.
Okay, my wife is being modest. She is the creative director at a big agency downtown. She's a big deal, works really hard.
Yeah, it's actually why we're here. I needed to de-stress and relax and just kind of forget about work for a little bit.
Oh, well, that is cuter than a porcupine. So sweet. What about you, Michelle? What do you do to relax?
Yoga.
You know, I've never tried that yogi jam. I heard it's good for your hips, though. I got barbed wire bones, you know what I mean?
Barbed wire bones?
Yeah, you know, when your bones pop up from your arthritis. You know, pop, 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 pop!
Mildred, what do you do to relax?
You know, I'm still figuring that out, actually. It's been a lonely 6 months. You know, the one thing I can tell you from being a widow is to treasure your time together. You never know, whoever up there decides to throw a wrench in your stew. And, you know, before it's too late. Oh, well, my puppies are done. All right, ladies, you know, this has been a real hoop. It's been so nice meeting with you.
No, you too. See you later.
Oh, Megan?
Yeah.
Don't tire yourself out like an old greyhound. You know, new rabbits come and go, but your soul goat is forever. Toodaloos!
So, does that make you my goat?
Oh, you bet your ass I am.
All right, hon, that's a sheep.
Fuck.
Thank you so much again for babysitting tonight. We really needed a night out.
Yeah, no problem. You know, they were great.
I'll believe it when I see it. All right, honey, I'm gonna be in the bedroom and get my sweatpants and my summer sausage on.
Okay. So great to hear. Yeah, they are good kids.
I know they're great.
I actually want to talk to you about this summer.
Yeah, we can do it.
So I know, like, for the past like 4 years, we've been doing like,
I love it.
Every day. Yep. My problem, though, is like, I now have a new job.
All right, here's the deal. If he gets his sweatpants on and if he gets into that sausage, I'm not having sex tonight, and I need that to happen.
Damn, I'm sorry. Get it! So happy you girls could come over and help me unpack and set up my redo.
Okay, Mom, it's a Roku, okay? And we know things have been kind of all over the place since the divorce.
Yeah, you know, and I think it's great that you let Dad have the house. You know, now you can start fresh in this place.
You know, I think you're right. Oh, I have a text message on my new iPhone.
Ooh, fancy.
Thanks, ladies, for the gift. Bridget said she's on her way.
Okay.
So, I'm so lucky to have three daughters who are on my side of the divorce.
Okay, well, Dad should have never cheated on you, so we are all clear on that.
OMG, I got a message from Phil.
Did she just say OMG?
OMG who?
Phil, I met him on Tinder, didn't I tell you?
Oh, no!
Mom, what are you doing on Tinder?
Yeah, I'm on Tinder.
But what are you doing on Tinder?
I don't have to answer that question.
Well, then neither do I.
Okay, how about you both answer the question at the same time? One, two, three, go.
Casual sex.
Mom!
Oh, get over yourselves. I'm 65, I'm single, and I'm ready to mingle. Okay. Tell us something about your father. 25 years, never went down on me. Not once. Think about your life.
Yeah. And
imagine that.
It's putting stuff in perspective.
Terrible.
Think about it.
I don't want to.
So, what did Phil say, Mom?
Oh my God, are you serious?
Well, why aren't you happy? Why don't you try it?
The answer to that question is yes, you do want me to be happy. Now look, I gotta open my app first.
I want you to just tap on it from the home screen. You just tap on it.
But sometimes it doesn't open when I click it.
Don't click it.
Am I using the wrong finger?
No, it can be just any finger. Okay,
it'll. Oh. You said DTF. What does that mean?
Donald the Fridge.
Donald
Douse the Flame.
Don't let that fire. Fridays.
Okay, well, if you girls don't know, I'm gonna have to put it on Google.
No, mom, don't have Google. Don't.
Okay, I'm gonna open my Safari. Google.
No, mom, you can just type it in the bar.
Yeah, the three letters.
Okay, I've been doing this on my computer for a long time, and this is a computer. I'm typing in Google.
Okay.
Okay, now I'm gonna type in the box. What? Wait, oh God, what happened?
Mommy, just hold it.
Okay, well now it just went black.
Okay, I don't get it to your password.
Yeah, mom.
I don't know, sometimes I don't know how to get my password back.
Just give it to me, relax. Okay, what is your password?
Oh, I put it on my password paper.
Oh my God.
It's convenient, I have all my passwords in one spot.
Yeah, one easy to steal spot.
Oh, it's my last four digits of my social.
Mom! You can't use your social as your password.
Well, when I die, you can get into my phone.
Or we're gonna look on your password paper, okay? Mom, you're not even on the Wi-Fi.
I don't know what that means.
The internet.
Someone come here.
The Comcast man set it up?
I have RCN, and Brian came.
Okay.
He's super sweet. You know, you didn't have to be on Tinder, because he seemed about your age. So.
What is the network?
Okay, he wrote it on my paper. Capital J, capital D, four.
Mom, you can go faster.
Six.
Faster.
Lowercase c.
Yeah.
Capital D.
Okay, mom, just what's the password?
All by myself.
Okay.
Oh. You know I love Celine Dion.
Yeah.
You know,
it's all in lowercase.
It was all in lowercase. You know, Celine Dion is like
mom,
a security animal.
I got your, oh, do it before it times out.
Oh, okay. All right, so far. What was I doing? What was I looking at?
DTF.
Oh, right. Do I need to capitalize DTF?
No, you can just type, it knows the cases.
Should I copy paste it from his message?
No, just type it in.
F me. Okay, question mark?
Optional.
Okay. Search, floating. Oh, it's taking a while.
Okay.
Oh, urbandictionary.com.
Don't look at that. It's fake news.
Is real news. And they made that all up. Fake news is real.
Okay, that's the next thing we're doing later.
Oh, he said down to fuck.
Yeah.
I know what I'm gonna message him. What's my new address?
No! You cannot text a strange man your address.
It's not safe.
I can do whatever I want.
No, don't, okay? Don't do it. Send something else.
Fine. I'll send something else.
Thank God. Yeah, he could get lucky and come here and murder a whole family of women.
Yeah.
It's a lucky day.
He is not a murderer. He's very nice. Look at him.
Oh, yeah.
That's side
card. Hi, guys. Hi, Mom.
Oh, Bridget, hey!
Mom, I just got a text from you. What do you mean you want to duck from behind?
Oh, I left my T9 on. I meant fuck.
Mom! Oh my God, it has been a week, okay? My daughter told me to shut up last night.
That's nothing, my daughter, smoking in the garage.
Wait until they go to college.
I walked in on my daughter sitting on someone's face.
Hang on.
Okay, here it goes.
And hello!
Hello, everyone. My name is Rose Rosenblatt.
And my name is Doris Rosenblatt.
Hello, and if you were joining us for the
first time. No, I'll tell them.
Let me tell them. Okay, here we go. That's a better angle. Okay. We are here at the Nordstrom Cafe. We send our niece Taylor on dates that we set up. There she is. And then we watch the whole thing.
Yeah, we film it on the Facebook Live.
Uh-huh. Taylor! Oh, Taylor! Taylor, hello! Hello.
Hi!
Tell our fans about all the other nice boys we set you up with.
Can you please not do this to me again.
Taylor, do you want that $2 bill in your Hanukkah card this year or not?
Sam from your synagogue.
Schmuck.
Alex from your knitting group.
Ha! Big ol' fagel.
Jonas, your Starbucks barista.
What a schmendrick.
Yep, yep.
Matt, there's some guy named Matt. I don't know where
he's at. Oh, that one was fun. Okay, yep. So what we did is 10 minutes before you got there, we went and we said, who here is single and also named Matt? And he stood right up.
We watched a Friends episode where they did it on this thing.
Uh-huh.
The iPad, on the computer.
Okay, now just turn around, Taylor. Smooth your sweater out. Smooth it out, just like we're not even here. Ooh,
we're invisible. Okay. You won't hear from us again. Okay. You know, I don't know why she chooses to wear that sweater on dates. Why doesn't she watch our Facebook Live program when it is?
Okay, well, first of all, with the sweater, I do not think that is a bad color for her. She looks pretty good in it. And as regards to the Facebook Live, it's hard for her to watch the Facebook Live as she is doing it while it is live.
I don't understand
this technology. I usually just ask Ma for help.
Rosie, I told you I don't want to hear about your cap tonight.
Well, I am sorry that Marv is the single greatest man I have ever had in my life.
All right, I'm not talking about Marv. I want to go back to the sweater thing.
I don't think it's the sweater so much as her issue. It started all last summer with that boy Alex.
Oh, they broke up and it broke her heart. Yeah. She's just not ready for love yet.
Love? Who said anything about love? I think she's getting the big D all over the place.
Okay. Oh my
God.
She's going through a bit of a whore thing.
And she broke.
It's like under a veil.
Like I was saying, she's a little nasty, okay? But she's going through a...
Oh, here he is.
Okay, now this is our Bridge Club friend Maude's brother's nephew, Taylor. Mm-hmm. His name is also Taylor. I think that is stupid.
I think it's stupid, too. But you know what? I think it was stupid for Taylor to name his own daughter after himself.
Oh, you know, he's always talking about how selfish and self-absorbed we are. I did not name my cat Rose, did I, Taylor?
Huh, Taylor? Huh? You weren't even looking,
no,
Taylor?
Taylor,
you weren't paying attention?
Turn around.
How do you know my name?
Please just ignore them. Okay. So you went to U of I, Chicago?
Yeah, majored in econ. You know, I have never eaten at a Nordstrom before.
Never eaten at a Nordstrom? Who is this boy? You know, I like that she goes for the hard-hitting questions quick.
Yeah, you know, she's got a good offensive. You know, options, she's a little aggressive, but I like a spunk.
Rosie, if I've told you once, I'll tell you again. Mom cannot talk to you.
I think he's telepathic, okay? I just look at him and I understand what he means. Oh, you know what it is. It's telecathic. Hello!
So I like just moved back from home, you know, recently. Yeah. And, I'm living with my frat bro. Like, he said he might know him, Alex Grossstein.
Shut up, Doris, I'm trying to listen.
Wait, you live with Alex Grossstein?
Yeah, but you know, we said it was cool if, like, we went out, because, like, you guys, like, wasn't that serious, you know, so it was all good.
Not that serious. We were together for 1 year exclusively. We practically lived together.
But, like, technically, you didn't live together, right?
Well, no, we didn't. I think that, you know, when you stay together,
I'm just going to stop you here. Like, you clearly need to get over him because, like, he's not into you. And, like, just being here for a couple minutes, like, I can see why. All right? So, I'm just going to bail. Like, I don't even know why my great aunt wants to. Like, I can't.
Who do you think you are? You can say that to my niece.
Excuse me?
Yeah, I heard you. You can say that.
Do I know you?
No, but you were about to know me. You think you can just saunter into Chicago, casually name drop her ex-boyfriend, and not expect any consequences?
What?
Yeah, that's right, because we are family, and family protects family. And I know that sweater isn't doing her figure any favors. And her haircut makes her look like a homeless.
Oh.
But she is the nicest, kindest, sweetest girl that I have ever known.
Yeah, and you know what? Maybe she didn't go to University of Illinois Chicago. Maybe she went to Indiana and drank the whole time. But it's a better school anyway. Plus, she's now a tax lawyer.
Ooh.
And she doesn't answer our phone calls or Facebook messages, so she's probably busy and important, right?
You gonna let your aunts talk to me like this?
Yeah, I am.
Oh, so deal with it now, kiddo. We are going to tell your great aunt Maude, and she will destroy you, you schwanz.
She just called me a penis?
Don't pretend you don't speak Yiddish, boyo. Uh-huh. We're going to call your great nanny Maude and tell her what a little penis you are. Now, we'll let you leave quietly without a fuss. We just need you to sign a release form.
Release form for what?
Oh, for a Facebook Live TV show.
I forgot we were recording. Hello, Maude.
Midnight on Friday night, which means it's time for America's newest game show,
Where Do You Wanna Come?
Let's meet our contestants. He's a senior at U of I at Urbana-Champaign, majoring in sociology. Please welcome Brad Stockton.
Sad, huh?
Next up, he's a junior banking associate in Minneapolis. Give it up for Chad Fletcher.
Salutations, America.
And finally, he's a high school football coach working on his tenure in Pittsburgh. Say hello to Brock Poundstone.
Hut, hut, happy to be here.
And I'm your host, Sarah Bunch. I'm going to be reading off a series of scenario-based questions. The man who buzzes in, you think you got a right answer? Go right ahead and buzz in. The one with the most correct answers at the end of tonight's game wins the respect of women who are tuning in. Let's play! All right, question one. You've been having sex with your serious girlfriend for over a year. She's on antibiotics from having strep throat, but she's feeling better and you want to get it on. She's on the pill, so you never use condoms. Where do you want to come?
Oh!
Brad.
Yeah. All up in that sweet pussy.
Wrong. Chad.
Paris.
No. Yes, wrong.
Hut! Hutches in her hand!
No. When a woman is on birth control and she's on antibiotics, it lessens the effect of the pill. So I would have accepted condom, diaphragm, or her mouth.
Why no hands?
She's your serious girlfriend.
Oh, never shit. Had one.
Wouldn't know. Okay, question two. You're trying to live healthier, so you make a kale smoothie with asparagus for lunch. You're not perfect, so you also smoke a cigarette before picking up your date. After your third dinner date at a hip organic restaurant, where do you want to come?
Oh,
Brad.
Yeah, down her sweet throat, right, girl?
No. Yes, Chad.
The capital of Thailand, Bangkok.
No, yes, Brock.
Hodges on her back!
No, the correct answer was nowhere.
What?
What?
Well, you see, since this was the third date, you're left with over-the-pants action or oral, but because you consumed ingredients that made your semen taste bad, you're left with not coming at all.
Okay, but what about a classy handy?
There we go.
There's no such thing.
Now show me.
All right, since the score is zero across the board, we're going to jump ahead to our speed round.
I love going fast.
Thanks for sharing. Okay, for this speed round, I'm going to set the timer for 15 seconds. You're all going to simultaneously guess the items within that category. The man who correctly guessed the most wins the entire game. Are you ready?
Yeah! Yeah.
All right. According to kingcom.net, which is a real website, you can create memorable jizz. Ejaculate that tastes so good, she'll want seconds. List the ingredients that create memorable jizz. Go!
Pepperoni, 10 sausages, 10 Big Mac, a large blooming onion,
a large
French fry,
medium French fry.
And it's time! Okay. Let's get a drum roll as I tabulate the scores. And for the 42nd week in a row, no one wins!
Oh, man.
I'm your host, Sarah Bunch. Tune in next week as more men across the country challenge themselves to...
Where do you wanna come?
Oh my god, how long have you been here?
Oh, on my second
Okay.
It's been so long since I've seen you. It's like been since the wedding?
Yeah, these 2 months have flown by.
How is married life?
You know, it's crazy. Mm-hmm. But it's different. And the exact same.
Okay.
I feel like the only thing that's different is getting to call my husband.
And that's what makes it so different.
That and the tax break.
Sure. Oh, there's my Abigail.
She's my new friend.
Hi.
Hi. Can I get you ladies anything to drink?
I will have another margarita, please.
Okay.
Can you make the Tiki Tango a mocktail?
Well, that's just three different kinds of rum and orange juice. So you want orange juice?
I would like a Tiki Tango mocktail.
Great. One Tiki Tango mocktail and one margarita. I'll have those right for you.
Thank you, Abigail.
So I have something to tell you.
I have something to tell you, too.
Mine is really big.
Mine is earth-shattering.
I'm pregnant. What? Oh my God, that's so exciting!
Are you kidding me? That's horrifying.
But wait, you can't be drinking. Excuse me, miss. She'll have a Tiki Tango mocktail, too.
Okay. You want juice also?
No. Just in my margarita. I had an abortion. Oh. Or I'm having one. I think I'm probably doing it tomorrow, but only if I cancel my dentist appointment.
I will get those drinks.
Hi. Oh, kids are so exciting. And you and Jerry have been together for 8 years. Don't you think it's time?
Oh, who are you, my mom? No, it's not time. Plus, we just got that new white velvet couch, you know? And I can't have a little kid's hands messing it up.
I don't think you get it. This is a divine intervention. We could be moms together. I can't wait to get big. I'm gonna like make people give me their seat on the subway.
Okay. Sorry to interrupt again, but I have 2 kids and that whole subway thing goes away like really fast.
Okay, thank you, Abigail.
Okay.
Plus, you can't eat sushi if you're pregnant, and I love sushi. So, also, I love drinking.
Okay, you can't be drinking while you're already pregnant.
Okay, but I'm not keeping the thing, so like, does it really matter?
I don't get it. Kids are so adorable. And you get so many Facebook likes on baby pictures, and you get to name it whatever you want. You know, like, celebrities like Christy Teigen, she named her child Moon.
All right, I don't know if I should be giving you these, but my shift's almost over, so fuck it. Here's one margarita, no salt, and one orange juice with extra garnishes.
You know what? This looks stirred. Could I have it shaken, please?
Sure.
Thanks.
Thank you. But here's the thing. My apartment is impeccable. It's right. Like so clean. I can't have a kid messing it up.
Right, but like kids are the best. And you can eat whatever you want. Okay, Leah Remini, she gained 80 pounds and then just lost it all.
Okay, yeah, that doesn't really happen in real life unless you have one of those, like, crazy intense personal trainers. And come to think of it, I think Chrissy Teigen named her daughter Luna, not Moon.
Okay, so thank you. But here's the thing. If you're pregnant, you can't go out. You'll never have a social life. It's like you can forget about drinking.
I'm having a Tiki Tango mocktail.
Orange juice.
Right, but I can go out if I want. Maybe I won't need to, though, because I'll have unconditional love from my child, right, Abigail?
Yeah,
okay,
I mean,
so,
like,
but,
yeah.
Like, you're never going to sleep or have any time, right, Abigail?
Well, that's not really the point.
So I'll get an alarm. I'll, like, save money getting an alarm clock.
Okay, shut up, both of you, okay? You are not listening to a single thing that I'm saying. I mean, what's the point of even asking for advice if you're not going to listen? And, sure, you won't be able to, like, have a clean apartment for a little bit. You won't be able to eat sushi for a while, you know?
Told ya.
And you, okay? You do not get to eat whatever you want. You're providing nutrition for this thing that's like growing inside of you, right? And you need more money, okay? Do you think I want to be a bartender at a Chili's in Vernon Hills? No, because you can never have enough money or time or sleep. You are focusing on like all the superficial things about having a baby. Like you get to watch this little thing that like split your vagina wide open and turn into a person.
What happens to your vagina? Because I really like mine right
okay,
now.
Okay, just drink your juice, okay? And yeah, there's a lot of things that I miss about not having a baby, like going dancing on Wednesdays, and I can't afford that pottery class I used to love, and
I used to wear suede boots.
And 15 strangers saw me shit on a table, okay? Just like popped out of me alien style, but it's worth it.
Is that real?
Yeah, that's very real. It happens most of the time.
They do not tell you about that.
No, they don't. And you know, I just think that you two should just like mull it over and like think about the big picture and the facts of like the big and the little and pay your bill and get out because my shift is done. And I get a 2 for $20 with my discount, so it's 50% off.
Save that money.
Yeah, I'm out.
Wow.
I never thought about actually being a parent.
Yeah, no, I really only thought about sushi.
You love sushi.
I do. I really love sushi. And I didn't say this, but I'm excited for you and Paul. You are going to make an incredible mom. You're so ready for this.
Thank you.
Yeah.
And that white velvet couch is really nice. I wouldn't want to mess it up either.
Thank you.
And you'd be a terrible mother.
Completely awful. Definitely shouldn't bring a kid in.
Oh, God.
Oh, what's wrong?
This is terrible.
That's because it's orange juice. Was a bit of a rough year, what with all the layoffs and all, okay? But I have decided to give you all a gift to show my appreciation.
A bonus?
A mug.
A mug?
An engraved mug. HR Puff and stuff over here said it would boost morale, okay? Get the show on the road. Here we go. All right. Oh, to the woman that mainlines LaCroix like an entitled hipster, Jen! There you go. All right. To the woman who heats up fish in the break room like a GD monster. It's Sharon. Yeah, there it is. We're having fun. Okay, here we go. To the woman who litters the office in passive-aggressive post-it notes telling me to clean up. What do you want, Mom? Nope. All right, here we go. It is your, what? Okay, so the syllables got to match. So it's yup, up.
No. Vet.
Oh, a veteran? Is it a veteran?
No, it's not.
Thank you for your service. I'm sorry, how do you pronounce your name?
Fuck you. That's not my name. That's not my
name. That's not my name. Okay, T-minus 30 minutes till the ceremony.
Yay, we've got the bride. That's what's important.
Thanks, Becca. Yeah. I feel like there's a million things I have to do before I get married. Like, do I have my passport? I should get my passport. Who has my passport?
No, Megan, we told you like 12 times you don't need your passport to get married, okay?
You know, if that's what they want you to think, Heather.
Okay.
The patriarchy.
Yeah. Okay, here's the thing. We're all dressed, we're ready, we just have to do our makeup now.
Okay, I said I would do my own makeup. Why did I do that? I don't know how to do a smoky eye with a new clip. I have no idea.
Okay, well, maybe we have one more co-maid of honor surprise.
Yeah. Why don't you tell that to
your professional makeup artist? Oh my God, this is such a good gift.
Okay, this is Sophie. She did all of the makeup for all of Carrie Underwood's tours and Hot in Cleveland. Yeah.
Thank you so much.
Yeah, I'm a little bit of a snafu on that one. Delphine's not here. An anvil fell on her makeup hand, so she sent me.
Wait. Okay, everything has to go perfect on my wedding day, all right? I took out a lien on my PT Cruiser to pay for this dress, all right? And one of you is clearly hiding my passport.
It's okay, I'm her assistant.
See, an assistant is just as good.
In training. I'm Madge.
When
you think about it, we're all in training, okay? So why don't we just have another glass of champagne and get our makeup done? Madge, would you like a glass of champagne?
Oh, no, thank you, miss. I don't like to miss alcohol with my pills.
Okay. I will go first.
I think that's a brilliant idea.
Okay, here we go.
thank you, girls, for giving me this opportunity. You know, when I first met Delphine, I was really in a rough patch. You know, you can only audition for the Pussycat doll so many times.
Oh, okay. I was not aware they were still a band, so that's new for me.
Oh, that might explain a lot. Okay. All right, you wore glasses, so I just did your cheeks and your lips. Voila! Okay.
Oh my god, oh my god.
Holy shit.
Oh my god.
Yes, nailing this. You know, my parole officer told me that I'm not a personality to be customer facing, but I'm showing him.
Your parole officer?
Well, technically, he's my second parole officer. My first one mysteriously disappeared.
Okay, this is not a good idea. I'm gonna get my passport and I'm gonna go. Okay?
Wait, we can make this work, okay? I look healthy.
Yep.
I look flush.
Yep.
Like a baby who just went for a run.
And they do that.
Okay?
Yeah.
Okay, so why don't you go next?
Great. Yeah. Happy to. You know what? I just really want a clean look. Just even out my complexion.
Okay, yeah. Here you go. I'm just going to do a little trick I learned from my friend Helen Mirren.
Oh, great. She always looks good.
May you know. She rest in peace.
Helen Mirren isn't dead.
Who am I thinking of?
I don't know.
All right. I need you to hold your breath. There we go.
You got it, man.
I look like an extra in Les Mis.
Yeah.
Oh, that's it. Helen Bonham Carter.
She is also alive.
Okay.
Oh, I'm wearing leggings.
Yeah.